Once we have variables, we can begin using them in science. Sometimes we use a categorical variable and a continuous variable together. So we have the categorical variable of male and female, and we measure a continuous scale variable of height in inches. Then we can compute to find out who is taller on average, men or women. But we could do other comparisons in exactly the same way with other continuous variables. Height, weight, average intelligence, parallel parking ability, time spent in the shower, anything. All we need is a categorical variable and a continuous variable. When we use variables for research, however, we need some new terminology to describe them. In research, we use independent and dependent variables. The independent variable, or IV, is the variable that is manipulated by the experimenter. The IV is the proposed cause, also known as a predictor variable. So let's say we want to do an experiment in which we test whether lab rats run a maze faster if they are given a stimulant drug. We randomly assign a group of rats to be in the stimulant group. So we give them cocaine and then we let them run through the maze. Then we compare them to a group of rats who received an alcoholic mixed drink. Who ran faster? In this example, the independent variable is what group the rats were assigned to, Coke or rum and Coke. The dependent variable, or the DV, is the variable that changes as the result of manipulation. It is the proposed effect, also known as the outcome or criteria variable. In our study, the DV would be how quickly the rats completed the maze, measured in seconds. Outside of science, we tend to think about life in terms of dependent variables or outcomes. Then we try to propose independent variables that matter. For example, do you want to be successful in life? Great, let's talk about that. How do you define success? What would have to happen in your life for you to feel that you have been a success? Those are outcomes or dependent variables. What will make you successful in whatever way you define success? What would you have to do to become successful? Those are your inputs or independent variables. In a scientific experiment, we start with the IVs and then we measure the DVs. So in an experiment, a researcher manipulates the independent variable. Then the dependent variable is measured under each condition of the independent variable to see if a relationship exists. Like, is there a relationship between becoming emotionally stable and later being successful in a marriage? If we measured people for their emotional stability and then measured them for their level of relationship happiness, would we find a link between those variables? For reasons I will explain later, we begin an experiment by guessing at the outcome of the dependent variable. It is kind of like betting on a horse race. You place your bet first, and then you watch what happens. In science, the win, place, or show is your hypothesis, and what we are doing is called hypothesis testing. Hypothesis testing involves drawing conclusions or inferences about whether the relationship between the independent variable and the dependent variable is more likely due to random chance or due to a true effect. The reason that we state our hypothesis before the experiment begins is to prevent cheating or simply making a mistake. It prevents us from looking at the outcome and speaking from our hindsight bias, exclaiming, "That's what I thought was going to happen." Instead, we say what we think will happen, and then we test to see if that is actually what happened. It's a little more complicated than that because we actually hypothesize that nothing will happen. It's called a null hypothesis. And then we test to see if something did happen. It's called an alternative hypothesis. What we want to avoid is what is sometimes called data mining, in which we just collect a large amount of data with no real hypothesis and then sift through the data looking for significant differences to write up into an article. Place your bets first. Finally, the individuals being studied in the experiment are called subjects. Now, actually, that's the case if they are non-human subjects. If they are human beings, we call them participants. So if you are studying animals, then your participants are subjects. But if you're studying people, then your subjects are participants. Make sure that you keep that straight.